study the relationship between the students' activity in a learning platform and the final mark. We try to obtain some indicators to predict the students' behavior and results. To do that, we did some experiments from data obtained from the e-learning platform of the University of Vigo. Specifically, we took the data from 3 academic years of a blended subject where the e-learning platform acts only as a complement. We did some experiments with the data. First of all, we calculate the correlation between the total number of interaction of each student and the final mark. As we can see, this value is a positive value, but it's not very high. Moodle has different type of events in base of what type of interaction the student did. There are view forums, writing forums, do some tests or kits. We try to detect what type of events are more related with the final mark. And we discovered that there are the events related with viewers or loans and contents or class notes. So from this moment, we only took this type of interactions to calculate our experiments. After that, we did the clustering in base of the daily number of access of each student. We obtained 2 groups, and if we represent the final mark of these 2 groups, we see that the first group has higher marks than the second group. In fact, the first group has a pass mark and the second group has a fail mark. So, to do more about this relation, we represent the time series of the number of interactions of the students with highest marks that are in red and the students with lower marks that are in blue. The dot points represent the test days. We can see that the good students enter more in the platform, especially before the exam. So after that, we decompose the time series into these components. And we discovered that the trend component gives us a lot of information about the tendency of the behavior of the students. In fact, we divide the students in 3 groups, students with marks higher than 6, students with marks between 4 and 6, and students with marks lower than 4. And we can see here that the students with higher marks have a trend higher also. So the trend component can be used as a predictor of the results. For example, if one student has a trend component similar to the red one, it's probable that these students are going to fail the subject. So as a conclusion, we can say that the number of interactions with the learning platform is related to the students' success, and that the trend component of the temporal selection analysis can be used as a predictor of students' results. In the future, we are going to extend our study to other courses in order to see if different course characteristics can lead us to different results, or if we can take advantage of this characteristic to improve our results. And as a practical application, we are going to develop a system to trigger alarm when students are in risk of failing the subject. This system would be a Moodle plugin. And this is all.